control. We have Tiqqun clearance for shuttle launch.
Initiate Stanford protocol.
All clear procedures. Check.
Systems are go.
Launch is imminent. Personnel are instructed to evacuate the launch pad. Empowered and pressurized. Munchie decontamination protocol online. Disembarkation authorized. Message to crew members. Welcome on board the Tiqqun, property of Dolos Aerospace Engineering Corporation. You will soon be given your assignments, but until then, please continue to wait near the docking bay. We hope you have a productive voyage. I would like to thank you for your contribution towards humanity's future. Administrator, I am Eden, the personal assistant installed on board the Tiqqun. In accordance with the Munchie protocol, I have been designed to take into consideration your complete psychological profile so that I may more accurately respond to any needs you may have. My primary purpose is to ensure the Tiqqun's automated systems function efficiently. I will keep track of the tasks that are necessary for you to fulfill your prerogative of reaching Proxima Centauri and carrying out field research, mining operations, manufacturing protocols, and Dolos colonization tests.
Administrator. I wanted to introduce you to your first tasks personally. I'm Dolos' cryonics lead, Marduk Council Member Giovanni Battista. So, let's see. Your first objective will be to begin setting up essential infrastructure aboard the Tiqqun, meeting the environmental conditions that are required to support your crew. Having laid these foundations, you will then oversee the installation of the Vol engine and perform a short test jump to Proxima Centauri. Upon arrival, your research teams will carry out a brief survey of local space, gather a few rock and coal dust samples, fire up the colonization protocol, begin building the foundations for mankind's future, yada, yada, yada. And then you'll come back. Now, in order to achieve this, you'll need to familiarize yourself with the Tiqqun's core functions. It's no big deal. There's the production, stockpiling and distribution of resources, construction, balancing of power output with allocation. Oh, and space exploration, you know, setting out expeditions and all that. Basically, everything needed to establish scientific advancement and harmonious autonomy on board the Tiqqun following the first test of its Vol engine. Eden's gonna display and keep track of your main objectives. Oh, and Administrator, don't let the position go to your head. Veneer has insisted to center Dolos' focus on the Tiqqun, but this mission is just in preparation for our next project, the Protagoras. The Marduk Council worked damn hard to pull this mission together ahead of schedule. So, toe the line, do as you're told, and bring the Tiqqun back in one piece. Leave the grand gestures and saving of mankind from ecosystemic destruction to us, okay? One last word of advice. We don't all think like Veneer Dolos. As of yet, no human law has been officially established amongst the stars. That sounds like an opportunity knocking to me.
Administrator, I have established a connection with Dolos' lead data scientist, Emma Klein.
Administrator, Mr. Dolos has made it abundantly clear when it comes to security. Given the importance of the Tiqqun, we must have full control over what is happening inside the station. My name is Emma Klein, Dolos' lead data scientist and member of the Marduk Council. My department have just completed final synchronization between Eden and our data treatment tool. The DLS. The DLS, or Data Listening System, is capable of scanning, recording, and parsing exchanges of any kind. The DLS programming that is a part of Eden will filter all data collected and bring to your attention only the most relevant information. It will also provide you with a condensed overview of any situations that may arise and formulate potential future outcomes. It will permit you to give direct orders without having to go through additional unnecessary paperwork. Eden will then take care of everything via their DLS accreditation. As is often the case with tools produced by my department, I think you'll find that once you start using the DLS, you'll never be able to do without it. Oh, and before I let you go ahead and start writing history, Dr. Munchie, our lead medical expert, wanted me to bring to your attention a possible side effect of vole jumping. Whilst there is a correlation between prolonged space travel and the development of early onset dementia, he believes that a vole jump has the potential to accelerate this process, although this is yet to be proven. His recommendation is for you to immediately send any crew members that are exhibiting uncharacteristic or symptomatic behavior to an infirmary, as these facilities are equipped to treat the mind as well as the body. Remember that all of your actions and choices are being reported by Eden. We are not affiliated with any national or even international organization. The only people that you are answerable to are those of us who sit on the Mardic Council, who represent the collective interests and ambitions of the company.
Administrator, a new request awaits your attention.
Thank you.
science ship has arrived at its destination. Science ship team has completed a task. Science ship team has completed a task. Jader, I have an incoming transmission from Wardak Council Member Henry Bargeville.
Toru, Administrator. What a wonderful day to embrace our fate, don't you think? I'm Henri Bargeville, writer, philosopher, lobbyist, but most of all member of the Marduk Council. I have taken the liberty of personally arranging an exchange, out of courtesy with the Ushanabi, a ship in high orbit belonging to one of our commercial allies, the Ashtangais. Even so, they are a small organization. The Ashtangais are important partners who share the same pragmatic, moralistic, and spiritual outlook as we do. The Ushanabi will provide us with a source of food whilst carrying out the Tiqqun's initial testing. By making it the first exclusive trade partner of the Tiqqun, we will demonstrate to our long-term allies that Dolos wishes for them to share in our successes. Please assign a cargo ship so that we can check the trade routines. Administrator, trust in genetic kinetics. Self-similar space will reveal the pattern.
Administrator, I have an incoming transmission from Dolos' head of medicine, Dr. Abhinav Munshi.
Greetings, Administrator. I'm Dr. Abhinav Munshi, Dolos expert in compartmentalism and medicine, and a member of the Marduk Council. I'm glad to finally meet you, even in this digital manner. Your psychological test results were quite impressive. My friend and colleague, Philip Stanford, couldn't be here today, so I will take the role of introducing you to the final stages of the whole engine integration. Before we get into that, however, we would like you to complete the testing station's exploration and enhancement capabilities. You'll then be able to begin researching the EVA airlock and assess its compatibility with the Tiqqun's core systems. I hope that the work of our team will ensure that you're equipped to deal with most situations you encounter up there. Before I leave you, Stanford would like me to remind you that space is a far less fanciful and forgiving environment than science fiction would have us believe. It would be wise to remember that.
A science ship team has completed a task. A science ship has arrived at its destination. A science ship team has completed a test.
Thank you.
Administrator, a new request awaits your attention. Electricity generation. Sector 1's power demand has overloaded. Stanford routines recommend that you construct an external solar panel to boost overall electrical output.